Hello and welcome back to Aprilia Futura ABS retrofit. In previous episodes, blah 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 blah. Does it fit here? No, it doesn't. It actually prevents steering. Does it fit here? If it doesn't fit on the left side, why should it fit on the right side? It interferes with instrument cluster anyway. Will it fit here? Almost. I think I found the place. I had to trim some plastic parts here and here. I really didn't want to move the battery, and there is not enough space to fit it right next to it. The exhaust just won't clear it. It's truly a tight fit, an angry fight for millimeters. I'm using a zip tie for the ABS unit to hold its place until I fabricate a stainless steel holder. There you go. A unit with brake lines attached is taller than I would wish for, and side fairings just won't fit without some trimming. It's hard to cut into a panel of a rare bike that was never damaged, still in its original paint, but it just can be done the other way. Little by little I was trimming it off, and its fitment was becoming better and better. And I found out why pressure switches came with rubber seals instead of copper type. Their sealing surface is far from flat. Not the fact to make me happy. Here's a sealing surface of a brake line. Much better. Or a banjo bolt with a bleed nipple. Now that's on another level. For a test fit, I put an adapter and a banjo bolt into an ABS unit and tried to fit a side panel. It fit with a bit of clearance, but there is a problem. Instead of an ordinary banjo bolt, I'm putting a pressure switch on this place, and the pressure switch is taller. Due to lack of space, these long joints are the thing to avoid at all costs. 5 mm of extra length is 5 mm too much. I have shortened it down to 2 mm extra, or so I thought. See? It's very limited space in there. When tightened, it proved to be just over 1 mm extra length, which is near perfect. I will use ABS for front brake only after rear proves to work flawlessly. So I fit an ABS unit with attached most brake lines and went to sleep. After all, it was 4:30 in the morning. Here's a bolt I will use to fit an ABS unit. Once again, I will use a stainless sheet metal to fabricate the holder. But this one will not be angled only at 90 degrees. This one will have to be bent to various angles to bind two bolts and clear some electrical harness near the ABS unit. 1.5 mm is thin enough for me to be able to bend it by hand, and hopefully strong enough to offer enough support for the ABS unit. Now I have to drill a hole at the correct position. I don't want to lose this. The battery drill always reminds me to charge batteries in the most convenient moment. Time to try how it fits. There will be a fat zip tie fixing an ABS unit to trim piece, so the ABS unit will be secured well. There. Looks pretty good actually. I've noticed that I have some wiring near the unit already, which is nice. But I also have a problem. This coolant self-bleeding pipe won't hold long. It will get cut through sooner or later. I'm thinking of one possible solution, but not today. A rear wheel speed sensor. I thought it would be a good idea to count rear sprocket teeth. That way I would avoid the use of a dedicated ABS ring. But will it fit? Not really sure, the rear swing arm is not the most promising shape. Well, that's one position that would fit, and that's one threaded hole that I could fit it to. Another stainless holder it is. This one will once again have to be bent by a funny angle. I had to make another one as I bent the first one with the wrong angle orientation. Oh well. The piece was too long to even try to fit. I had to shorten it first, making sure I don't shorten it too much. Measure twice, cut once, they say. Or in my case, cut, measure, cut. Not the best way, I know. One of the reasons I didn't clean the swing arm is you can draw onto dirt. And I will turn that into my advantage. The drill took me a bit off, but nothing serious, it is just one hole. However, I will have to be accurate when drilling another hole that will prevent the holder to rotate. Looking sweet, that's exactly what I wanted. I wired the sensor to the ABS unit and an oscilloscope and checked the signal. A nice stable square signal. Time to finish the holder. I have to secure this position by fitting another screw so the holder will be unable to rotate. A tiny screw will be more than enough. Now, I am not a fan of drilling into an aluminum swing arm or any other structural thing, but one little hole shouldn't weaken anything enough to cause any real danger. The wheel speed sensor cable will be routed together with a factory speed sensor cable, a brake line and a pipe for chain lubrication. I replaced the brake line with the one coming from the ABS unit. The old one was leaking, so I cut it to see how it's made. It's a Teflon interior, a stainless steel braiding and PVC cover. It is not high heat resistant, which is the reason why it failed. Reassemble everything, including a chain oiler jet, which is the best invention just after the motorcycle. And the wheel speed sensor is neatly hidden behind the chain guard. Nice!
I see you next time!